Using the Relationships Window to Define Relationships. You may find it easier to view this video in full screen mode. Let's start with one possible relationship between people and jobs. We need to understand what business rule applies to the relationship we are trying to define. One possible business rule is that each person is assigned to one job, and each job can employ many people. We are starting here with the relationship window open. If the tables are not shown in the relationships window, use the Show Tables dialog to display the tables you need. Since we are defining the relationship between people and jobs, let's add those two tables to the diagram. A relationship diagram can be easier to read if you position tables from the one side of the relationships to the left and tables from the many side to the right. According to the business rule, there is a one job to many people relationship. So we will put the jobs table on the left and the people table on the right. At the moment, we can't create a relationship because the people table does not have a field to indicate to which jobs a person is assigned. It is possible to modify a table's design right from the relationships window. Right-click the field list for the table you want to modify, then choose Table Design. We can call the new field Job ID to make it clear that it corresponds to a similarly named field in the Jobs table. Because the new field will be used in a relationship with an auto number field, we should assign to it the number data type with a long integer size. To create the relationship, drag the Job ID field from the Jobs table and drop it over the Job ID field in the People table. The Edit Relationships window will pop up. This window displays the two tables and the fields being used in the relationship. Notice the field of the window also indicates that this is a one-to-many relationship. Access can determine this because we chose a unique field in the Jobs table. Job ID is the primary key of the Jobs table and therefore must be unique. In the People table, Job ID is not unique. So we have a one job to many people relationship. It's a good idea when you create a new relationship to enforce referential integrity. Referential integrity will ensure that we can assign a person only to jobs we already know about in the database. Without enforced referential integrity, it is possible to create records in the many table that do not have a corresponding record in the primary table. So you could assign a person to a non-existent job, not something you would ordinarily want to do. You do not have to explicitly save a relationship after you have created it. If you close the relationships window without saving, the diagram will not be saved, but the relationship is saved. Now let's look at creating a relationship between people and jobs when a different business rule applies. In this example, each person can be assigned to many jobs, and each job employs only one person. Remember that for any given situation, only one business rule applies. The tables are the same as we just looked at, but the business rule is different. The business rule indicates that the relationship is one person to many jobs. So we will put the people table on the left and the jobs table on the right. This time, it is the jobs table that needs an extra field to identify employee assignments. We will modify the jobs table and create the relationships in the same way as we created the relationship reflecting the earlier business rule. Thank you. now we have a one-to-many relationship between people and jobs. Let's take a look at yet another possible business world, one that is more likely to reflect the real business environment in which people are associated with jobs. Remember that work assignments do not exist at a single point in time. In the course of normal operations, even if a job requires the efforts of only a single person, the actual person doing the job may change over time. In the same way, over time, any given person seldom has the same job assignment extending across the full term of his or her career. Most likely, then, the relationship between jobs and people is many to many. Each person can be assigned to many jobs. Each job can employ many people. In a many-to-many relationship, we use a third table to store the foreign keys. Notice that this table includes one field for each table's foreign key, and a pair of date fields to indicate the beginning and ending dates of the person's assignment to each particular job. Here, the many-to-many relationship consists of two one-to-many relationships. So we put the people and jobs field lists on the left and the junction table field list on the right, and then create the relationships. In this video, we have shown how business rules determine the type of relationship that exists between two tables in a database and how to use the Access Relationships window to create and manage table relationships.